In this video, we'll take a look at a second example involving the one sample t-test. And here in this example, we had the scores for 30 different people on this variable that we named perception here. And for the background of the study in this hypothetical example, we wanted to know whether people view a politician as either significantly favorable or unfavorable. And what we did here, 30 people were asked, once again, hypothetical example, but 30 people were asked, how do you view blank, whoever the politician's name is? And then they were asked to respond on the following scale. They could respond from highly unfavorable all the way to highly favorable. They had to choose one of these. So, for example, the first person who was asked this question, how do you view the politician, they answered a 2. Which indicates that they viewed that politician somewhat unfavorably. The second person chose a 3, meaning they viewed the politician slightly unfavorably. The third person chose a 5, they were slightly favorable, and so on. You can see the ratings here. Now, what we're going to do in SPSS for the one sample t-test is, remember, we want to know whether people view the politician as either significantly favorable or significantly unfavorable. 4 is an answer that indicates they didn't view the politician as either favorable or unfavorable, but it really was a neutral response. So we want to test in SPSS whether the opinions of the 30 people differed significantly from a 4, as a 4 indicates a neutral response. Once again, neither favorable nor unfavorable. So 4 will be our test value in SPSS. Okay, so this is our population mean for all intents and purposes. We want to determine if people rate this politician significantly different from neutral. And we're going to run this test as a two-tailed test and use alpha of 0.05. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So here we'll go to Analyze, Compare Means, and One Sample T-Test. And then we move our variable perception over to the test variables box. And then remember this test value box, we need to put in whatever our population mean is. And in this example, it's a 4, which indicates neither favorable nor unfavorable, so a neutral response. Remember, it's very important to always put the test value in this box, not to leave it as the default value of 0, unless 0 happens to be what you're testing against. But this is a very common mistake, so be sure to put the population mean in the test value box here. Okay, that looks good, so next let's click OK. And then we get our output here that opens up in the viewer window. And we can see that our 30 participants had a mean of 4.23, which was just slightly above neutral. So in other words, in the sample at least, the opinions were slightly better than neutral, so slightly favorable, with a standard deviation of 1.43. Now looking at our one sample test table, this is where we're going to evaluate whether or not the test is statistically significant. That is, do people rate the politician significantly different from a neutral response, which was a number of 4 in this example. So looking here at our p-value, notice that we have a p-value of 0.379. Now, if you recall, we're going to use the decision rule that I described in the previous video on the one sample t-test. So we'll use the following rule.